Alright fans, welcome back to OFW Extreme. It's the second match of the night. It is Jacob O'Neil facing Andre Perfection, but it's probably one of the biggest challenges slash matches that Jacob O'Neil has, the Next Gen Season 1 winner. And he's going against the big guy, Andre Perfection. It's going to be a tough match, but it is a tournament title matchup. So therefore, it is a lot on the line here tonight in this matchup. And Jacob O'Neil was the rookie of Dustin Clark. He's got a lot of influence behind Dustin Clark, and hopefully we'll see it tonight. But as I said, Jacob O'Neil won Next Gen Season 1 and really has, you know, he's been making a name for himself in matches, been a really impressive guy, shown his, you know, impressive skill. But he has not won a championship yet. The only achievement he has won, you know, is the Next Gen winner. So therefore, he needs to, you know, put his name on the map and win some form of championship. And he is trying his best within OFW. Of course, though, the toughest, you know, tough opponent is the, well, now would be classed as the former Rising Star champion. Well, apologize, former television champion, Andre Perfection. Of course, he was the Intercontinental champion, but that championship has changed and returned to the television championship. So, you know, he is fighting a former champion here tonight, Jacob O'Neil. And here comes Andre Perfection. He thinks he's Perfection, and he comes down, you know, showing, you know, his power and showing that, you know, he is coming out here a man on a mission, you could say. And he looks dead serious, and you know, he's got to focus on tonight, because I believe, if I recall, the next round the winner will be facing Dustin Clark, if I recall. So, you know, it might not be Dustin Clark, I believe it is, by checking the tournament brackets. So, you know, he's a former world champion, you got to be on your game. And I think Andre Perfection maybe going to be a little bit more serious than normal. Usually coming out all cocky and arrogant, but I think tonight he's going to be a little bit more serious within this matchup. And there's the bell, and here we go, another world title tournament qualifying matchup. And again, just like in the previous matchup that we saw between Rex Smith and Robin Storm, it is speed versus power. And Andre Perfection is showing the power here by lifting up Jacob O'Neil in the atomic drop. A big shoulder barge down. As I said, Jacob O'Neil, use your speed. And there's the speed I was talking about. The big heel kick right off the bat straight away. Couple of in, and the Jacob O'Neil now speeding up. He's got to keep the match speed up. Wait, one, two. No, only one guy, I apologise, but I say Jacob O'Neil's got to use his speed, but there we go. His speed went against him, you could say. Now, Andre Perfection, once again, back on the offence. Andre Perfection is a powerful guy, but also a very technical one. And, you know, since coming into OFW, he's been, you know, he's been a very controversial guy. He's been saying stuff what's on his mind. He's, you know, been saying what's on his mind. He's been winning championships, and a lot of people don't like him, of course. His former friend or his best friend, I'm not sure now, Petey Skaggs, who was in OFW, the Perfect Playboys. One, two. No, only a two count, I was saying. The Perfect Playboys. Andre Perfection most probably has only ever had one friend within OFW. As a, you know, Jacob O'Neil there with the float over DDT. Heading up on top. They're going to bounce off. Lands the big splash. And this could be opportunity now. Look at Jacob O'Neil now. Oh, goes over. Oh, misses. And Andre Perfection is going to take that advantage and throws Jacob O'Neil into the air. Saying this, you know, since returning here, it's you know, very, really, really important for these men to make a name for themselves under the new general manager, Rose. You can make a name for yourself. You know, you could get in the good books with her, and she will do her best behind you. You know what I mean? We're pin one, two, no, only a two count. As I'm saying, with the new general manager being Rose, a lot of people can now most probably make a name for themselves in OFW. Where's Jacob O'Neil? Jacob. Oh, God, Andre's. Oh, wow. Jacob O'Neil now. Oh, Jacob O'Neil now. He's got a springboard. Oh, no, misses, crashes and burns. But I was saying, with Daniel Barber was the general manager, he just basically played favorites and no one could make a name for himself. Rose is saying it's even game now, so therefore these guys here tonight will be trying to make a name for themselves. Oh my god, Jacob O'Neill's busted open. Returning to OFW, someone's already bleeding here. It's Jacob O'Neill, and I think Andre Fesh has got to try to go for a count. No, he breaks the count, but you know, Jacob O'Neill is in serious dire straits. Oh my god, oh, pounce! Oh god, a T-Bow suplex slam. Oh god. Oh my god, wait a minute, no. No way, not the perfect bomb on the outside. Oh my god, oh my god! Jacob O'Neill could be out of it here. Jacob O'Neill looks worse for wear here. He does not know what the hell is going on. He's just been put... Oh, God, now he gets thrown to the steps. Jacob O'Neill, perfect bombed on the outside, back hitting the concrete floor in the back of his head. Oh, gets elbowed in the face. Jesus Christ, I think Jacob O'Neill... He is out of it here. Oh my god, and he's just going to receive punishment now. Jacob O'Neill, I think that the perfect bomb really just put him away in another T-Bone suplex. T-Bone suplex power slam. And, oh god, now look at this. Lift him up again. He's going to go for a second perfect bomb. And, oh, there it is. The perfect bomb onto Jacob O'Neill. One, two, three, this match is over. Andre Perfection advances here tonight, but wow. Jacob O'Neill, I think Jacob O'Neill was out of it when he got perfect bombed on the outside. I honestly think that was the end of Jacob O'Neill. After getting busted open and then receiving a perfect bomb, that was it. And well, congratulations to Andre Perfection, but fans, we got to go to a break now. We'll be right back as we got a tag team matchup coming up. It's Toxic versus the Mega 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 Powers. Fans, we'll be back. Well, fans, welcome back, and we just saw the confrontation between the new general manager, Rose, and Daniel Barber, and it seems that Daniel Barber is objected to Rose being the general manager, which means it's going to lead to votes, and apparently it's going to lead to votes in 2 months' time. And I believe that's going to be at the third CPV. I'm not too sure, it might be the second, but we need more information on this. Fans, with what's going on, because at the moment a lot's going on and it's getting out of control. The fact is, I know for a fact that former general managers can object to the new general manager, which then leads to a vote. But the vote don't tend to happen, because 9 times out of 10 the new general manager gets picked is the right choice. Of course, originally Daniel Barber was meant to be the right choice, but he went a little bit insane, and you know, that's what we got now. And it seems that we got a war between Rose and Daniel Barber over the spot as the general manager. Well, anyway, we're gonna move on here. Right now, we're going into some tag team action. It's the Toxics versus the Mega 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 Powers. Yeah, Mega Powers. And of course, Macho Hogan and Macho Slats. Of course, the Toxics are a really impressive up-and-coming OFW tag team They've been doing really well, but tonight they're going against a really interesting team here of Nacho and Macho Slacks. It's the mega power. Yeah! You can tell on their t-shirts, most probably a tag team that somehow came along and is just loved by the fans here. And, you know, loved by the fans, they love the fans. Nacho Mania and Macho Slackness is just running wild here in OFW, and it has been for a long, long time. And the fans just love Macho Hogan and Macho Slacks, you know. And of course, it's just, they're a pretty amazing tag team also, which is shocking. That's another shocking thing. But anyway, here we go, and it's the tag team titles tournament matchup, and it's starting off with Bromine and Slacks. And Macho Slacks, they're getting the fans behind him, and Bromine is trying to get the fans behind him, and Macho Slacks is telling the fans to get behind him. Their fans are split down the middle, it seems, into this matchup, and Macho Slacks is doing the twirl. Yeah, the twirl. And you know, here we go, here's a lockup. No, Macho Slacks gets R-Reg, or takes the hide. Macho Slacks headlock is thrown down by Bromine, and here we go again. It's like a reset here. Bromine's getting the fans. No, Macho Pele by Macho Slacks. Oh my god, what? How does he? I don't even know how Macho Slacks can do that. He just Pele's. And Macho Slacks, oh, big forearm into the back. Bromine reverses. Bulldog there by Bromine. Toxic's now got the advantage. I have no idea how the hell Macho Slacks can do a Pele. He just does it. It's just a Pele out of nowhere. Bromine now. Bromine. Oh! Oh! No, missed with the missile drop kick. And now Macho Slacks working on the arm. Yes, he twists the arm around. Goes into a camel clutch. A very unorthodox camel clutch. He's working on one arm. And now Macho Slacks sees to have all the offense for the mega powers. That's too many megas in that, fans. And now Bromine reverses. Starts working on the legs of Macho Slacks. Takes out the legs. He caught really Cloud's top rope for the Slacks elbow. And now he's going to tag it to Austin now. Look at this here. Look at him working together here. Look at Austin jumping off, kicking Slacks in the face. And now Austin now trying to get the fans behind him. And he's going for a pin on Macho Slacks. I think his feet was in the ropes. And there's a kick out. And oh, Slacks! Oh, wow! Power of Slacks. Now Slacks, drop kick to the face. Onto Austin. And now Macho Slacks, an orthodox net breaker. And now he's going to tag you into Nacho Hogan. No, he's going up on top. Oh, no, changed his mind. Oh, no, wait, no, he's going onto the other rope. Maybe it's... Oh my god! Oh my god! Slacks elbow! Slacks elbow! No, misses! Oh man, the Slacks elbow missed there! He pointed to the fans and he crashed and burned and... Oh god, and now Nacho Hogan coming in. Nacho Hogan with the miss with the spinning kick. Gets into a headlock. Knee into the face. Oh, wait! Bulldog there by Nacho Hogan! Former Cruiserweight Champion, former OFW Heatwave Champion, Nacho Hogan. He's got tag team, he's got, apologize, titles under his big belt. And now, Austin splashes Nacho Hogan. Now he's picking up Nacho. And now, Bulldog on Nacho Hogan by Austin. And now, Nacho Hogan, oh my god, look at this. Oh, god, that was Austin's finisher there. I believe it caused toxic injection. One. No, only a one count here. Macho Slacks breaks it up after the toxic injection onto Nacho Hogan. Now Nacho Hogan. Nacho Hogan, look at this. Arm ring kicking Austin into the face. And then what's Nacho? Nacho! Nacho! Oh, springboard splash! No, I don't know how Nacho Hogan does this. No, kick into the back of Austin. Now, what's Nacho Hogan, former Cruiserweight Champion, been gonna do in here? Oh, what's he? Oh, kick! Oh my god, look at this! Oh my god, spin, it's a flip, power bomb! One! No, only a one count and fans, we've got to go to a break.